we're discussing the family Malvaceae. Malvaceae is a very simple to understand family, and the reason why I'm starting with Malvaceae family is we have seen the flower which is placed in this family, and that is China rose, or it is also known as hibiscus. So it is one of the very common flowers or plants that we normally study. As I told you earlier, that in a family, everything has to be given in a very precise manner. There is root system of this family plants. They have different type of flowers, inflorescence, various things. But when we are talking of families, we will start with the flower. If there is inflorescence, we start with inflorescence. And if we are talking about only flower, then we need to describe the flower using only the terms. Sentences are not written whenever we are describing it. So I'm going to write certain words describing this flower, and then we'll understand the meaning of all these words. The flower is pentamerous hypogynous complete actinomorphic hermaphrodite. We have written only the words. Each word is giving us an information. Pentamerous means every part is in multiple of 5. So the number of sepals, petals, everything is going to be 5 or multiple of 5. That is 5, 10, 15 and so on. So that means it is pentamerous. Hypogynous, that means all the whorls are arranged or attached to the receptacle below the gynoecium. Hypogynous is for gynoecium. That means here the ovary is going to be superior. Flower is complete. That means all 4 floral whorls are present. Actinomorphic, that means it can be cut into 2 equal halves through any blade. And hermaphrodite, that means it is bisexual. Now, we will write one more term here. In this family, though we have written the example of China rose, but we are talking of the family. So in this family flowers, that is flowers belonging to this family, they can be bracteate or ebracteate. That means both types of flowers are seen. They may have bract or they may not have bract. Now, after flower description, we'll take up different words. In case of Malvaceae family, there is an extra whorl which is known as epicalyx. There are small green structures and their number is normally 7. It ranges from 5 to 7, but normally 7, and they are free. Then the whorl which is inner to it is calyx. There are 5 sepals. They are gamosepalous. That means the sepals are fused. 5 of them and gamosepalous. Velvet aestivation. That means the arrangement of these sepals is such that there is no overlapping of these sepals. They just connect end to end. Now coming to corolla. 5 petals. Polypetalous. That means the petals are 5 and they are free. Here we find androecium is attached at the base of the petals. So attached to staminal tube. Once we understand the structure, we'll know what exactly the staminal tube is. So petals are attached to staminal tube. Aestivation is twisted. twisted aestivation, and the petals are showy. That means they are large and brightly colored so that it can attract insects for pollination. So we know 5 petals are there, they are free. There is an attachment of the petal with the stamen and the aestivation is twisted. Coming to the next word, androecium. Number of stamen is very high. So we write many stamen are there. Anthers are monothecous. Monothecous means they have only one lobe. Normally there are 2 types of anthers, monothecous and dithecous. So here it is one lobed or monothecous. Monoadelphous condition is seen here. Monoadelphous condition. Now let us take these words and understand it. Many, that means number of stamen are very high, is very high. Anthers are monothecous. Now when we write monothecous means it is a single lobed anther. Monoadelphous condition. Adelphous condition or adelphous word is used when only filaments are fused but anthers are free. And mono means one. That means all the filaments have fused to form one bundle, and through that bundle passes the style, and that bundle is known as the staminal tube. That means if many filaments have joined to form a pipe-like structure through which the stigma style is going to pass, and that staminal tube is attached at the base of the petal. So here we have written that the petals are attached to staminal tube. Here we have to write that the stamen is attached to the petal. And we know that this term is known as epipetalous. So the condition is epipetalous here. This is about the androecium. Now the next and the innermost whorl is gynoecium. It is, the ovary is pentacarpillary, syncarpous with exile placentation. Exile placentation. And the ovary is superior. Ovary is superior. Now, with this information that we have, can we write the floral formula and can we draw the diagram? We have understood the meaning of all these words, and using this information we are going to be writing a formula. Now the first thing is the formula. Now formula, we said we start with breath. So here they may have breath, so we write it as BR or EBR. That means it can be bracteate or ebracteate. After that, the next thing is symmetry. Here it is written that it is actinomorphic. So here we have used this. We have used actinomorphic symbol. The next symbol is whether it has both the sex organs or not. So it is bisexual or hermaphrodite. So here we have used this word, that is hermaphrodite. Now we will come to the whorls. In case of Malvaceae family, there is an extra whorl, that is epicalyx. So it is written as epicalyx, K for calyx. And we said the number is normally 7. We have not put the bracket around this number 7. That means they are free. Now coming to calyx, the number is 5. There are 5 sepals and they are gamosepalous. That means they are fused. So we have to put this number in bracket. The next one is corolla. There are 5 petals and they are polypetalous. So we write 5 and we don't put the bracket around it. androtium, many. So we write infinite. And if we say monoadolphus condition, that means filaments are fused. So this infinite is also put in bracket. And the last is G, that is gynosium. It is pentacarpillary, that means five carpels are there. And it is syncarpus. Syncarpus means they are fused. So we write five and fused. Ovary is superior. Flower is hypogynous. So the line is put below G. So this is the floral formula for Malvasy. One more thing which we have to add here, and that is epipetalous condition. That means the androtium is attached to the petals. So this is the formula of Malvasy family. And here we have written of the family. So we have written both the possibilities which can be seen. If we are taking an example of a plant, and if bracts are present, we will not write EBR, and if bract is absent, we will not write BR. So then in that particular plant, we have the flexibility to give the specific information. But here we are giving all the options. So from all this description, we have come to this. Or if we interpret this, we are going to get the same description. How are we going to get this description? This formula tells us that the flower can have bract or may not have bract. So flower is bracteate or ebracteate. Are we seeing all four whorls? That means flower is complete. Are we seeing both the reproductive whorls? Then the flower is hermaphrodite or bisexual. Are we seeing a connection between A and C? That means the condition is epipetalous. Do we see all the stamen together? So it is fused condition. Do we see line below G? That means flower is hypogynous, ovary is superior. So basically when we see the formula, we are getting the information which we have written down here. And that is why we say that the floral formula is basically in short description of the family. Now once we have understood this, we have to learn how to draw the diagram. So this is the floral formula, and as I told you in the beginning itself, that the maximum questions which are asked based on families are on three things: formula identification or certain feature identification on the basis of formula. The second thing is the floral diagram which we will be drawing, and then the economic importance, that means the important plants belonging to this family. Now in the next part, we will use the same information to draw a floral diagram, and we will try to find out some important plants belonging to this family.